one and all. Let me first congratulate Dr. Somu Singh ji for creating this platform of Bharat Padhe online campaign. As you can see, this is the very special platform, and this is the 74th lecture. That means before that 73 lectures have already been done here on this platform. I'd like to congratulate Somuji for creating this a very important platform at this crucial moment. So once again, I congratulate him and start my lecture. Today I thought of going to give a lecture, but I want to discuss on a topic that is mental health of the students during and the post COVID, and role of the teachers and parents. Here are two things we will be discussing. Two things are associated. One is mental health and the other one is the condition or the status of the students during the COVID or the post-COVID era. So first, before going to the students' mental health during and post-COVID, let us just very simply know what is mental health. I won't go into very depth of this part of mental health, because our main target is the situation of the students or impact on them during and the post COVID period. So, but simply, if we know, or if we like to know what is mental health, it is the condition of our psychological maturity. WHO in the year 2001 had rightly given a definition on mental health, and that is, it had defined very broadly about mental health by saying that it is a state of well-being. It is a state of well-being in which individual realizes the potential in him or her, and with that potential, the individual likes to perform in the society. They perform in the society with the potential that they are having, and they realizes their potential, and they contribute to the society or to the community where they live. So it means, from the definition given by WHO, is that mental health is a very important state of our life, and it is the foundation of our life. It creates the base of our mind, and mind ultimately leads to the well-being of our body, soul and everything. So from that point of view, if we see, it is the base, it is the foundation of our everything, which ultimately help us to have a good and a very normal life. So it's a condition of personal and social functioning with a maximum effectiveness and satisfaction. Person with a good mental health can work fruitfully. The person with good mental health can work very very much with satisfaction from what he works. So it's a part and parcel of our life, and without mental health, body cannot function. The main thing is that mental health is related to the performance of our body. It just leads to our body. The mind is ultimately indicating us. One finger even you cannot lift up and down if your mind is not sane. So that means, to keep the mental health is so very important in our life, because ultimately it is guiding the entire body. So this is in very general, from the very general term we are talking about mental health. Let us not discuss the technical terms related to it, because we are to do the other part more seriously, because this is the really situation where we are going through. We have to cope up with the situation. So a mentally healthy person is always socially adjusted and a physically well person. It is considered to be that. So imagine if the mental health is not going on properly, or if it is not rightly going on, we are not deriving it properly, how can it impact on our mind and body? As I said, mind is related to body. Mind indicates we are working. Mind stops indicating, mind stops directing, we stop working. So it has got its direct effect. So now that the situation of the present situation that we are facing with the new reality. New reality, why we are saying? Because everything has become new. Our type of working, we are working from home, children's schooling from home, some temporary unemployment problem. We are detached with the family, we are detached with the students, students are detached. So everything is very, very new, which earlier we were not ready to get. This situation has arisen, and this has given us a very new situation in front of us. And as a result, it has got its again impact on our mental health. This is quite natural because, as I said, that mind is the main area, main director, which is directing us. So this, during this period, what actually we are going to concentrate is the status of the students and the role of the teacher as well as the parents, and at last the role of the government also I'm going to discuss with you. So during this situation of COVID, it has got direct impact on our mental health. As a result, we are getting such kind of results from the performance of the students, from their behavior, from their interaction, that it has become a real challenge before us. Challenge before the teacher, challenge before the students, and challenge before the parents. And the most vulnerable group here is the adolescent students, because this is the period of storm and stress, and they are the worst sufferer of this situation. And children, they are quite known and quite unknown also to the situation. That is why they are in a very confused state of mind. They are in a dilemma. What is going on? When the things will be over? When we will get the normal situation again back in our hand? So how we will again be going to school normally like before? So they are at a confused state. Even the situation had its impact on the adult student as well, because they are at this stage, things are very competitive, they are into competition, they are very much oriented what aim they are, what vocation they are going to pursue and all. So this sudden changes of this situation has it has got its very bad effect, I would say, to a section of people. And additionally, we must recognize that 90% of the students are the members of the of a particular age group. And according to UNESCO, UNESCO data, around 2 to 3 billion students are affected by this situation around the world. This is the current situation. Since we are into teaching learning process, we will be mainly concentrating on the impact of COVID on the health, mental health of students. Rest, we will again some other time we will discuss. We will be mainly concentrating on that. Now the new situation has arisen, and it has changed the entire situation of our life. The students, mostly they are missing the schools. Earlier, initially, it was a very happy kind of situation. I must say, students were very happy that, okay, now that schools are off, we are off from the school, so we don't have to school, let us enjoy staying at home. But gradually, after 1 month, after 1.5 month, after 2 months, now that 2.5 and nearly 3 months have passed off this lockdown, it has started its impact on the mental health of the students. Now gradually, students are realizing what they are actually missing. They are missing their school, first of all. They are missing their peer groups. They are missing their favorite teachers' class. They are even missing the teachers who were not much favorite to them. They are missing their classes also. teasing the teachers, fighting with each other, sharing the tiffin box, then writing something, cartoons, making cartoons on the blackboard, the morning assembly, which is very serious. Students get a lot of value-oriented, learning during the assembly period. So many things that generally goes in the school hours, they are missing it. As a result, there are certain behavioral changes we are observing in them. They have become very irritating by their nature, and they are very confused. They are very there's a lot of worry about their current classes, current chapters, how they will finish it up. And it's not from the part of the students, it's from the part of the teacher as well. This is the most, the pathetic situation. Lot of challenges not arise in front of the students, but also in front of the teacher as well. Teachers are suddenly, they are to shift from one type of education system to the another. Let us say that there is a paradigm shift of our education system in the world in general and India in particular, and situation has arisen in such a intensity that all of a sudden teachers are to equip themselves. But here also there are certain problems arise here. Teachers who are, as a result, some section of the teachers have risen, and one section of the teacher is a bit lagging behind. This is happening mainly to the people who were not at all well versed with the technology earlier. Maybe the teachers, the senior teachers who are on the verge of retirement, they don't like to be a part of it right now, but by force they are doing it, finding lot of difficulties. And due to lack of knowledge on the use of the appliances, they are facing a lot of problem. Connectivity is the issue here in India. If you go to the remote parts, there is no electricity 24/7. There is no network connectivity. Teachers also who take classes, in between they get problem, or there is a lack of connectivity. So this way they are finding problem. They are not being able to correlate everything to the students. They are not being able to assemble the students together, because this is not through the face-to-face mode that generally they are doing from the beginning. Since the beginning they are doing it, but they are the online facilities suddenly giving this kind of challenges in front of them. And the students, they are losing in their field. They are feeling very, very loneliness, because at home they are inside the home, lockdown. Though in some family there are 2 to 3 children, mobile maybe 1 or 2, not sufficient, because all families cannot afford to have one mobile to each of the family member, for each of the family member. That way, then there is the absence of physical proximity of the students with the teacher. This has totally changed the situation of the teaching learning process. Teacher also unable to get or unable to have physical proximity with the students, and students with having no connectivity with the teachers, no physical proximity with the teachers, they are also at a losing state of their mind. So in this regard, parents become very much worried as what to do and what not to do. So intense sadness, worry and anxiety is the situation right now, because of loss of activities, loss of exercises, and loss of physical touch, socialization. These are totally now, I can say, totally absent from the situation. Now the financial setback is also a problem, is an issue here in our country. Relocation, then absence of physical proximity, as I have already told, and the students have become very aggressive in their nature. They have become very aggressive. They are not replying properly to their parents, and teachers also, through online mode, they are unable to relocate the students, for which they are also at a state of confusion, what to do, what not to do. Since corona is a medical issue, now we have to live with it. This is the ultimate acceptance that we have to believe in, that corona, it's a it would continue for a period. You never know how long. But the right now everything, the first unlock, first phase of unlock is going on. Though the first phase of unlock is going on, still everything is open, but children are inside. Schools and colleges are closed. So, and additionally, there are other issues related to their frustration, because see, some children's parents both are working parents, and now that people are going for their, people have started going for their job also, mobile phones, if it is one or two, parents take the mobile phones with them. As a result, students are unable to get mobile, and even if they get one, if one parent leave their mobile phone at home, the if the children are more than one in the family and the classes are going on at different levels at the same time, तब मुश्किल उन लोगों का आते हैं. एंड दिस इज़ अ वेरी क्रूशियल मोमेंट, बहुत ही क्रूशियल मोमेंट है हम लोगों के लिए. इट्स अ वेरी चैलेंजिंग फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स. इंडिया में ऐसा नहीं है, ऑल द स्कूल्स आर और ऑल द पीपल आर फ्रॉम द इलाइट सेक्शन. वी हैव स्कूल्स विच आर फॉर द मार्जिनलाइज सेक्शन. मार्जिनलाइज लोगों के लिए जो स्कूल्स है वो कम्प्लीटली शट डाउन है. Schools which are meant for the disabled students completely shut down hai. So schools, the government schools are shut down. Already government schools has got very less facilities, but the private schools again all are shut down. So people are, the school principals are also in a dilemma whether to open or shut down the school completely. Earlier I had a discussion, very recently I had a discussion program with the school principals. So there is the contradictory remarks I have noticed among the principal. One section of the principals, they like the schools to get open very soon. On the other hand, one section of the principals, they are feeling that they are just, you know, requesting with the folded hands that school must not be open till at least September or November. So from this confusing state, if the schools, we don't know when it will be reopening again. Kab khulega, we don't know. Theek hai, agar 2 mahine ke baad school khulega, to fir there is a very... there is a question mark regarding the 100% or the 100% attendance of the students. So in this regard, opening of the school also will create problem. Half will come, more than half will not come. So how the teacher will coordinate? So these are various kind of you know, situation that have already arise not only in our country but in the entire world. But we are, since we are living in this country, we will be mostly concentrating about the problems of this country. Ek baat yahan pe aur aate hain, that students, once the society will be divided into two parts. One part will be having, those will be having facilities at home, jaise ki mobile hai, with each and every member of the family member having one mobile. वो एक सेक्शन होगा. एंड वन सेक्शन विल बी डोज हु हैव ओनली वन मोबाइल और मे बी टू मोबाइल, बट द मेंबर्स आर मोर देन 4 or 5. इन दिस रिगार्ड देयर विल बी अगेन द पीपल विल बी डिवाइडेड. देयर विल बी टू पार्ट्स ऑफ पीपल, हैविंग एंड नॉट हैविंग. नॉट हैविंग मीन्स द टेक्नोलॉजिकल डिवाइसेज, द मोबाइल फोन्स और इंटरनेट कनेक्टिविटी एंड ऑल. सो दिस वे देयर विल बी अगेन confusion, there will be again a problematic situation in front of the teachers. How to deal, how to tackle, how to solve, how to reunite the students again. Kyunki school mein hote the, there is no issue. Students aate hain, they are under the complete observation of the teachers. Parents are also very much in a state of relief that okay, children are in the school right now, teachers will control them, they are under the supervision of the teachers, we don't have to bother. Teacher right from the disciplinary activities se leke, khel kood se leke, relaxation se leke, storytelling, story narrating, fun loving programs, many things, they एक जो पार्टिसिपेटिव पेडागोजी, व्हाट आई विल से, दैट इज टोटली एब्सेंट नाउ. ऑनलाइन में क्या होते हैं, यू नेवर नो योर चिल्ड्रन आर पार्टिसिपेटिंग और नॉट. यू विल सी इफ दे विल ऑफ द वीडियो और दे विल ऑफ द साउंड ऑल्सो, ऐसा भी हो सकता है एक राउंड लेके घूम के आएगा, ऑनलाइन होता हुआ दिखाएगा, एक राउंड मार के आएगा, फिर एट लास्ट अगेन दे विल जॉइन बाय सेइंग थैंक यू टीचर ग्रेटफुल टू यू टीचर लाइक दैट. So here again there is no guarantee that 100% participation is occurring or not. These are the challenges. So kya ho raha hai? This way it has got its impact on the overall development of the students. Generally school mein ye sab regularly hota rehta hai, all round development also going on. लेकिन यहाँ पे जो है ऑल राउंड डेवलपमेंट विच इज़ वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट. मेंटल हेल्थ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इफ इट इज़ पॉसिबल इफ देर इज़ ऑल राउंड डेवलपमेंट. इफ माइंड बॉडी इमोशनल डेवलपमेंट मॉरल डेवलपमेंट इंटेलेक्चुअल डेवलपमेंट स्पिरिचुअल डेवलपमेंट फिजिकल डेवलपमेंट मेंटल डेवलपमेंट इफ इट इज़ नॉट राइटली ऑकरिंग इफ इट इज़ नॉट राइटली इंक्रीजिंग पॉजिटिवली देर इज प्रॉब्लम एंड देर actually we are facing problem. Behavioral changes इसीलिए आ रहे हैं because there is no all-round development that is taking place. So this impact of this situation, lockdown or what I would say that impact of COVID-19 has got this kind of, it has created this kind of serious issues. In some part of our country still some Sanskrit tolls are existing. They are completely imparting face-to-face teaching, and these tolls are completely off now, completely shut down, for which they are having problem. Then some school meant for the marginalized section, some schools in our country are such, I have visited those schools are meant for the marginalized section of the society. They don't collect the fees from the students also. Instead of fees, they are to carry the garbage that is at home. They are to carry that, and the school again recycle those garbages and create something which is very socially useful product. This way they get the value of their work, value of everything, and this way schools are running. So poor connectivity, as I already at the beginning I told you, connectivity is the issue in any way you do through online connectivity, it just fluctuates. Then this challenging situation, as I have told you, arise not only in front of the students as well as in front of the teachers as well as in front of the parents also. Now we are at a dilemma how to cope up with such situation. So my viewpoint in this regard would be that since this will go on and on, so we ourselves have to be prepared a bit in order to cope up with the situation. Mental health subject also gives us strategy to cope up with the situation also. The person who is having problem, they how to cope up with that situation, how to get out of that situation. Now getting out of this situation is completely it's beyond imagination. Now we have to live with it. Now it's a part of our life, so better why not we cope up with the situation. And in this regard, the role of the teacher and role of the parents are highly important, since these two poles are very highly and very closely associated with the students. Some students are very smart and some students require lot of effort from the teachers, from the from the parents as well. So in this regard, the smarter students, they are very smart in using the electronic device also. So one thing we teachers, most of the people here following this lecture, they are into teaching profession. I am into teaching profession. So let us accept the fact that students are smarter than us. There's no harm in accepting that. So smarter in the sense that they are very fluent, they are very efficient in using the digital devices. We, the teachers, I have to agree with this thing. I have to actually appreciate the school teachers that within very few days, say 10 or 15 days, teachers have grasped the use of the electronic devices. Since the challenge has immediately come in front of us, teachers initially they were at a very at a stage of dilemma, but gradually they immediately realized that no, this is the fact, this is the reality, we have to follow these devices, we have to better live with it. So a section of the teacher, I have to say, they have adopted the digital devices very quickly, and the school teachers, I would say, they are doing tremendous job right now. Many of my schoolmates, many of my college mates, they are into school. Some of them are here also in this group, or they are maybe watching also today. So I really congratulate them for their commendable job. They have learned, because earlier we never use the digital modes in the classroom. We are into face-to-face mode, and actually face-to-face, actually there is very there is no replacement of face-to-face mode. Let us just accept that, accept the fact. But since the situation, this situation has arisen in front of us, we are bound to use the electronic devices. And in this regard, again, there will be two sections of people. One section of people will rise up very quickly, because they are, like, I won't say young or aged, I'm not saying that, but people, some who are very, very enthusiastic in using the digital devices, they will rise up very quickly. One section who are not much into that, yes, regular use of Facebook, WhatsApp is something different, but utilizing this online classes through various apps, or using the web portal, putting the assignments, putting the activities into the web portal, allowing the students to use that, doing something and uploading into the portal, these things are something, like, you know, they are not very much used to. I have this, Monica ma'am is watching me. Monica ma'am, is that day she told me that, Babli, I don't like to use all these things. You people are doing this with digital devices. So you people are getting a lot of fun. You people are utilizing your time. But for me, face to face, ma'am is a very great personality. She's a principal, retired principal of a reputed school. So ma'am saying that bubbly face-to-face mode, something which cannot be replaced by anyone. I totally agree with you, ma'am, because there is no, substitute. Koi iska substitute ho hi nahi sakta. But anyhow, since this is a medical crisis, we have to apply it, and we are using it. As I said, there will be two section of people of using or enjoying it, and not very much enjoying, but using it. So this will again, there will be a division. Let us just accept it. And the thing is that students who are very much, as I told you, they are smarter than us, and let us accept this fact. So students will find interesting the content with the teacher who is a bit digitally sound, using very nicely, or applying it, adopting it nicely. The students will be enjoying with that teacher very much, and the teacher who are not so very much well versed, I won't say technologically ignorant teacher, no one is ignorant, but some use it a lot, some use it very less, so they will find a bit difficulty in coping up. So this way there will be two parts of, again, the teachers for on using or utilizing the digital device. But anyway, we are into the system now, and we have to utilize this. Now the fact that has arisen in our life is that how we make it properly usable, how can we utilize it at its best level? This is the question, this is the challenges. First of all, the situation has to permit us. We have to have connectivity, good connectivity. We have to have proper devices. We have to have electricity connection. These are the three things where India is, our government is still, I mean, lot more to work on this. So these are the three main sources, three main actually tools, I would say, which are very much highly important in using this. Then the school, then the teacher, school or colleges or whatever I said, they have quickly adopted this online mode of teaching by any using any say app or say any other mode, but still the teachers are in a state of confusion regarding various parts of their teaching, like deliberation of lectures or deliberation will definitely go on, but regarding say giving assignments, okay, then how to collect the assignments, how to assess the assignment, what kind of assignments, like these are the matter of concern now in front of the teacher. Secondly is the how to assemble the students, how unified form of teaching learning situation they can create through online. In face to face mode it was very nicely possible, but how to have that through online mode, this is the big question in front of us. I myself am doing online classes with my students. I am finding it very difficult, but trying my level best to make it interesting. My students are adult students. They are not the young, I mean they are young, not the children, but they are adult students, mostly the teacher educators I'm dealing with, but still I find lot of problem, and still I find as if there is a gap between them and me. This is severe in case of the school teachers. Now in this regard, the role of the teacher, let us discuss that very seriously. What role teacher can play here? What role the teacher? Definitely lot of challenges, but one day we have to cope up with it, we have to live with it. But what to do and how to start? In this regard, my observation, it says that first of all, what we need before applying, adopting any technical devices, my point is that we have to develop the attitude. First of all, attitudinal change. We no more can afford this thing that again the previous period, previous days will come in front of us, and again we will be having going face to face mode. This will be completely over and we will be back to our previous situation. Let us just not think that. Let us just not do any mistake by thinking that. Let us better accept the reality and think that and accept that and change our attitude that yes, this is going an ongoing process. This will go on, and better we have to adapt it, we have to cope it. This is the attitudinal change. This is the mindset. First of all, changing the students or making the students to learn the coping up strategy, better teacher first of all cope up the situation. Teachers first of all get the training. Teacher better learn first. Teacher better get the training first. So it is from the part of the teacher that we have to accept the fact and we have to change our attitude. Secondly, what I feel is that we have to be very empathic. Empathy is very important and very need of the hour at this stage. We have to have patience of hearing the students. We have to have patience of understanding their issues. We have to learn, we have to understand that students, they are not from the same background, whether you call it social background or financial background, it's like up to us how we take it, but this is the fact that all are not coming from the same background. There are differences in their situation, social, financial, physical, whatever we say, emotional. Let us just better understand it. As a teacher, we have to develop that patience. We have to be empathic, because student already they are missing the peer interaction, closeness with the students, interaction with the students. So teachers are now their backbone. Teachers are now their backbone. Who will understand them better if the teachers do not? So let us be very patient towards them. Let us be very kind towards them. Earlier in face-to-face mode, teacher used to scold the students, used to give small punishment. This was also enjoyed by students. They used to name the teachers, this is missing by the students. Let us just accept the fact. Students give name to the, no matter how good you are, no matter how bad you are, they will give you a name. It's a good or bad, it's up to them. They just do that. This is their life, student life. They enjoy doing that. They are missing quite a lot. So nothing is going on proper in their life right now. So we as a teacher, we have to be the backbone of their life. So this mindset and empathy is the very primary habit that we have to form in us as a teacher. Then the enhancement of the relationship. At any cost, we cannot bear the loss of establishing breaking up of the relationship with the students. We have to be constantly in touch with them, though online, offline, whichever mode, through WhatsApp, through Facebook, through Gmail, through email, whatever way is possible. Let us just not disconnect from them. Let us get connected. Earlier, one period teacher used to spend with the students. After that, they leave, they go home, and again next day they come. But now we have to be constantly in touch with the students. At any cost, we cannot lose this relationship, because we have to build up. In this regard, principal can take very good leadership, because principal's ultimately behavior, principal's leadership will improve this situation very much. That is what my belief is. Then develop the positive feeling in them. Allow them to filter the negative elements that are coming, that keep coming into their mind right now. Because children, we are talking about various sections of children. We are talking about the lower primary, we are talking about the primary level, we are talking about the secondary level, we are talking about higher secondary level, we are talking about the higher student, though we are not considering right now much about the higher education students, but still our target is the school children. So their mindset, their attitudinal change, positive cordial relation establishment will definitely boost them up, and they will again start believing into their life what they have lost earlier. And in this regard, teacher just can play a very big role. Let us be the content creator. Teachers, most of the teachers are doing, they have started already doing this thing, that teachers must also have their own lessons. They should create their own lessons. Though there are a lot of platforms, good platforms MHRD has already given to us, like Swayamprabha, Diksha, and so many, whatnot. So, but even then, let us create our own content. School teachers, the teachers must create their own content and try to, teach the student, deal the students with their or through their own content, so that they can also enjoy. Teachers can also enjoy doing so, not only depending on the already prepared classroom contents. And let the teacher also to acquire the critical thinking. It's not from the part of the students only. Let the teacher, as I told you, more than the students, the teacher will have to learn in this situation right now. I'm emphasizing on this topic in every platform where I got opportunity to speak on that. Teachers better be a good trainer, teachers better be a good learner, teachers better be a critical thinker, and he can collaborate communication and develop skills and prepare them for their future challenges, and adopts certain confidence building measures. Teachers must themselves be very confident for doing so. They must have to adopt certain confidence building measures. Teachers must also develop the attitude of techno-savior. Whether we like it or not, we are bound to accept it. We have to follow this. We have to take this. Let us upskill and upgrade and get ourselves well-trained first. Train under, in order to train the first on first generation of online learners. We are going to give online education to the first generation of the online learners. In order to have that, better we get ourselves very much skill and upgrade our skills. Then rescheduling of annual calendar of the school. This is a very serious issue. This is a very serious work from the part of the schools, that we have to reschedule the annual calendar of the academic year. In rescheduling, flexibilities should be adopted. Schools cannot afford to have rigid schemes in rescheduling the academic or the annual calendar. Here the teacher's role is very, very principal, and the teacher, they can have meeting, they can have very flexible method, flexible courses, flexible activities they are to include. Then teacher should be very proactive. Thing is that, see, this is the situation right now we are going. God forbid, I pray to God not to happen this kind of situation in the future, but we have to be prepared for facing any kind of situation in future. So for that, we have to be very proactive. We have to be very well equipped. We have to be very skillful in order to deal any kind of situation. Then the teachers, again, I have to say, is that one very important aspect of adopting into the new situation by the teacher is that curriculum framework of the teacher education program. This is again high time that we should think about, the curriculum constructors should think about the reorientation, revamping of the school curriculum. The teacher education program. This is from right from the elementary level to the higher level. It's not that only elementary education, teacher education program requires revamping, reorientation. Right from elementary to the higher education level, revamping, reorientation, reimagination is very, very important. So revamping of curriculum from elementary to higher secondary level is very important. Multi-level strategies are to be adopted, as I told you. So our strategies should be very, very it should be on multi-level strategies. Then training for all levels of teachers, right from primary, and mostly while revamping the curriculum, practical content should be put more into the curriculum, since this situation is demanding lot of online classes, lot of online using of lot of online devices. So the curriculum should also include that way the contents which are very which would be very helpful for the teacher. This I would like to request with folded hands that this is very urgent now. Then opportunity should be given also to the teachers for developing innovative methods. Now, as I told you, role of the teacher is more important here. So in order to have develop innovative methods to handle or tackle the situation, opportunity should also be provided to the teacher. Opportunities related to say like infrastructural facilities, okay, and flexibilities regarding the innovation of various new and applying it. So a lot of flexibility is to be given. What I would say, one important thing is that blended learning is a good option. Now that situation is such that you cannot have fully online or fully offline classes, blended education is a better option. And for blended learning, blended education system, again opportunities must be given to the teacher. So development of unified learning system need to be developed. Post-COVID learning will be mostly self-focused learning. Here, self-focused learning, it indicates that students will learn as per their convenience. Student will choose their subject as per their interest, as per their space, as per their time. So in this regard, teacher's role will be like a facilitator. Teacher will no more be a very active instructor in this regard, but teacher has to provide all the facilities to the students. So in this regard, teacher will play the role of a facilitator. What we require is also the right database. where teacher can create the content and right kind of repository system is highly important, so that students whatever they want they get it at immediately, within minute, within seconds in their hands. So that kind of, you know, facility should be there, and this would be at this hour very helpful for the students. Good mobile learning modules again are to be prepared. I would say innovative ideas and solution for the inclusive children. We cannot keep them apart from the regular students, from the normal students. Inclusive students, they are very special students. They are a very important part of our life. They are very important part of our educational system. In face-to-face mode, there was no problem while discussing, while imparting to them. But we cannot neglect them right now. Their importance should be given to the inclusive students, and treating them, educating them, teacher must get good infrastructure, good opportunities to develop curricular content, having right kind of teaching method, developing innovative ideas for them. Innovative ideas for the disabled students, they are very important part of our life. Disabled students, they are specially challenged children. So for them, innovative ideas are to be introduced. This is what my feeling is. Then flexibility of courses is needed, so that at time, whenever, whatever, they can choose as per their interest, as per their time, as per their space, yes. At any cost, the relationship should be maintained. It should not be detached teacher-student relationship. There is no question of detachment. Let us reach to the students through some initiative. Already MHRD has taken initiative. They had created some platform like Swayam Prabha, already I told you, Swayam, then Diksha. These are very innovative. They are providing higher form of, you know, education with good quality materials, with providing right kind of, you know, adopting right kind of method by the teachers. But what I feel is that more people are to be included into this system, so that we get more innovative ideas, more easier method to impart, more good materials, and so that children do not find any problem while learning. And one more important thing what I feel is that competency-based learning. By competency-based learning, what I mean is that there are certain aspects which we must take care of, that is the skill development, ability, potentiality, and good habit formation. This I would say is the very much important, and amalgamation of knowledge, skill, habit formation, potentiality would ultimately provide us, enable us to have competency-based learning. This way, the teachers have to prepare themselves, prepare the content, prepare their mindset also. Then, I would not say last, but one important thing is that 4 hours to keep in mind by the school, while I'm not imposing everything on the teacher. School's role is also very important here to play. So 4 hours, I have named them, and these 4 hours, I'm saying that is reimagine, resolve, remediate, and reinvent. Reimagining, we can boost up the mental health. We have to boost up the mental health. Resolving, integration of arts education, easier education, arts education, fun-loving, storytelling, all these kinds of education which is very much fun-filled education. Remediate, I'm trying to say about that teacher training from elementary to, again, this I have already spoken about that. Then the reinvent is the revamping of the syllabus of teacher education. This is the need of the hour. This is highly important now. We cannot afford to have the traditional syllabus again and again in our education system. Situation have changed, needs are changed, so why not the curriculum? So curriculum for the teacher educators requires a drastic change. I would say drastic in the sense it requires a good change with innovative contents. Then policy reforms regarding opening and closing the schools by maintaining the social distance and all, this is totally again in the hands of the principals. At primary level, mostly the easier form of say like craft, art, drama, all these kind of which has got fun, yoga, story narration, etc. Why are we only imparting the contents to the students? Through online also we can have these programs, we can have portals, let them create their art, let them record their own dance, let them create their own recitation, let them create record their morning prayers and upload it on the portal. On that basis we can give them, we can judge them, we can mark them, we can give them prize also. This way their their enthusiasm will again come back where it has somewhere it is lost in this the COVID situation, and that enthusiasm somewhere it has died away, and we need to bring that enthusiasm back somewhere, because this is ultimately is the source of our mental health. If we lose our enthusiasm, life will be meaningless, and from this early stage if they lose this enthusiasm, very harmful for their all-round development. Then standardized remote learning practices, this is very important. This is here again school can come up along with the in collaboration with the government, I would say. Reform also is required for equitable access for the marginalized section and the out of school children. As I already told in this platform that there are certain school in our country where the marginalized sections are very specially treated. They are being treated. Some NGOs have come up and they are doing great job in our country by giving emphasis on the education of the marginalized section. These are completely shut down, but again we need to relocate, restart, and somehow we need to again continue the system. Then system of compensating learning, what has been lost, how can we compensate that? We need to think about that. Then financial investment, this is from the part of the institution, from the part of the government. This again I will come at the last, the role of the government where we require government's help and assistance. Financial as investment and reintegrating the students, this already I have mentioned that reintegration of the students is must now. Then diversified critical communication, let us have that very seriously. Develop mechanism to fight the growing demand of the mental health issues, and let us upgrade our skills. Okay, let us upgrade our skills and the teachers, and let us just have some non-academic, non-scholastic area in our syllabus. So through this we can I feel we can overcome much of the problem. So this is from the teachers. I have spoken much from the point of view of the teacher. Since I am a teacher, I feel very responsible that I should we as a teacher, the teacher fraternity, we should work harder on this. That's why these are all for the teachers, and since most all teachers are watching, so our role, friends, is very crucial, very important here. Then as in the title I have mentioned that role of the parents also we cannot deny. Here role of the parents is very important. Parents require lot of patience. Now the situation is that I tell you, very interesting things are going on in the school. Students are breaking things at home, students are quarreling with each other at home, parents are just complaining that school khula hone se hi acha tha, kab school khulega, we will be relieved and all. This is the situation. But in this regard parents require a lot of patience, because these are the things that students are doing. It's not because they are enjoying out of frustration, out of confusion, out of their worry state of mind. They are doing it, they don't know, even they are not realizing it even, that they are doing all these mischiefs. So parents require a lot of patience in this regard, and parents require patience in from one more aspect, that is that parents are very worried about the future and the current issues of the students. That school education is suddenly stopped, the school going and coming are is suddenly stopped and they are into this online education. बहुत सारी चीज़ें जो school में होते थे नहीं हो रहे हैं, right from assembly to the एकदम final leaving of the school. बहुत सारी चीज़ें, student used to enjoy teacher's punishment even, I would say. So बहुत सारी चीज़ें जो नहीं हो रहे हैं, parents सोच रहे हैं कि बहुत सारा disciplinary activities जो school में होते थे वो नहीं हो रहे हैं. It is highly troubling their life. So that way they are very impatient for which I would suggest the parents to have their patience. Then guideline, this is very important. I have spoken this on another platform also. This is my realization, this is my totally my feeling is that some sort of guideline should be prepared for the guardians as well. Dr. Somuji kindly noted down that we need to have guidelines for the teachers, the parents as well, because now the parents' role is very important. Now earlier students used to spend most of the time with the teachers, now most of the time they are spending with the student, with the parents. So parents in this regard, they cannot stay in a state of dilemma. Rather, they should get some guideline and they should perform accordingly, because they are also suddenly into this situation and they are quite unknown of this situation, and now they are not knowing what to do, what not to do. So this is the guideline to the parents that will help them to cope up with the situation. We all need to cope up with this situation, so is the parents. Then creating conducive environment at home. Parents must assist the students. Homework teacher ने दिया है, homework should be less. ये बात मैं teachers role में कहना भूल गई. School में बहुत सारे homework देते हैं. Yes, you can give homework, but that homework should be enjoyable by the students. Homework that they can enjoy by staying at home and doing. And in this regard, parents must assist the students to complete their homework or the assignments. Then the parents need to understand their children, and they should have full touch with the teacher, and teacher also try to have full contact with the students. See, school band hai, so parents teacher meeting completely chut gaya hai. So in this regard, teacher can have contact, constant touch with the parents. Jiske paas acha digital facilities ho, like the student ke saath jaise online classes karte hain, meeting you can have with the parents on any whatever, through Google Meet or any other app. Agar jo suvidha, agar jiske paas ye suvidha nahi hai, people can use offline messages, phone call kar lijiye parents ko, text message bhejiye, nahi to audio bana ke khud ka bhejiye parents ko, so that they can understand, they can grasp what they need to do with the children. Then frequent meeting, already I have told that we must conduct as a teacher frequent meeting. Abhi to meeting aur zaruri ho gaya hai pehle se. Then the parents should support the children emotionally and morally also. So constant support from the parents is very important right now at this moment. And the filtering of the negative thoughts that comes to the mind of the student constantly, frequently. So किसको कैसे filter करते हैं, negativity को कैसे नहीं आने देना, how to welcome the positive thought, positive feeling. This is again parents role to be played here. Then develop again positive attitude. Parents, it's not that parents will give big lectures. Parents will give sufficient time to their students. Now that parents are also at home, yes, koi ja rahe hain, office kar rahe hain, but still the parents have sufficient time for their children. Utilize it very fruitfully. Utilize it with the children by discussing their problems, how to solve them, and enjoy at home with leisure activities and get the pleasure. Teacher should guide the parents that not to force the student. ऐसा हो जाता है आजकल पेरेंट्स को, मैंने बहुत देखा इन माई नेबरहुड ऑल्सो, आई हैव सीन पेरेंट्स आर कॉन्स्टेंटली फोर्सिंग द चिल्ड्रेन दैट ये क्यों नहीं हो रहा है, ये क्यों नहीं कर रहा है, लॉकडाउन में हो तो यू आर बींग सो केयरलेस एंड ऑल. नो, टीचर मस्ट इन दिस रिगार्ड हैव फुल कॉन्टैक्ट विद द पेरेंट्स, एंड टीचर मस्ट इन दिस रिगार्ड प्रोवाइड गाइडलाइन टू द पेरेंट्स दैट बी काम, बी पेशेंट वाइल डीलिंग विद द स्टूडेंट्स. सो एंड regular participation of the parents in the meeting with the teacher is very much important. Keep updating the information to the parents is very to the teacher by the parents is very important. Otherwise, the problems that they are facing, if new problem arise, it will be left unidentified. So parents must be in constant touch with the teacher. Last but not the least, if time permits, then I would say that initiative from the government side. This, though I have kept last, but some important points I would like to mention here regarding the initiative by the government is that government must think about the educational system that presently we are having, must think about it thoroughly, and accordingly government should also provide facilities, especially the electricity. 24/7 electricity in the remote areas, we have that problem, serious issue of electricity. If no electricity, how can online education take place? So government must take care of this issue of providing electricity 24/7. Then one thing I have noticed, I don't know people, how many of you will be agree, that internet packages are very costly, costly here in our country. So what actually happens is that ek mobile se sabka nahi hota hai, do teen mobile ki zarurat hote hain, tab jaake expenses bahut badh jate hain of the internet packages. Har ek parents may not be able to provide it. So why not government should realize this fact, government should understand this fact and provide free internet facilities, or if not free, at least very low cost internet facilities government should provide. So many things have been talked, but now ultimately aisa nahi hai ki school will take some responsibility, parents will take some responsibility. Now finally one organization has to come up and take the issues and handle the situation presently, what present situation in college, in higher education. We see that University Grants Commission is handling, they are monitoring, financing, regulating the higher education system. That way higher education is very much, well regulated. But regarding school, there is no such authority, there is no such organization who can handle the various issues like this. Why not we have an organization, we can have an organization for management, for regulation and for financing for the education of the school. School education is very important. This is the base. This is the base that is given, and this base ultimately creates our future. So why we are neglecting school education? Why we are not thinking about school education so seriously? So this is my folded hand recommend through this platform, that can we have a school management committee so that it can take the entire responsibility of the school, and school will come into a proper systematic, we can have the systematic institution by calling it a school, like higher education, UGC is controlling it, and school, the school management committee, if that kind of any committee will handle lot of problem, we can overcome and we can have a good schooling system in our country as well. This is my final request. This is my concluding here by saying that where there is a will, there is a way. If we have a will, we can find our way. There is no problem in that. So finally, I thank you all for your patience that you are watching me, giving me comments. Though I could not read it very fast, some of your comments, I can see that. I wholeheartedly give my thanks to Dr. Somuji. Somuji, you are doing a tremendous job by creating this platform, because this is a platform, this is a very special platform. What I feel is that before me, great personalities, the eminent personalities of this country have spoken on various important issues, and those were very successful discussions. I don't remember I have missed any of the discussion. This is the 74th discussion, you can see. So you can now realize that so many good eminent speakers have already spoken. Thank you, Somuji, for having me into this program, I mean into this platform. I'm privileged to get this opportunity. And one more thing I would like to mention here is Rashmi ji, the wife of Somuji. She is the constant support giving force to Dr. Somuji. I always find her active in this discussion program. They have very two tiny kids. Somuji and Rasmiji have got two tiny kids. In spite of the tiny kids, still she managed to, you know, be active in this program, always in this, she becomes a part of this discussion program. So I really thank both of you, especially to Rasmiji. Keep supporting Somuji like this, and Somuji, keep going like this. I wish this program will go on, and we will finally be having a very improved system of school education in our country, so that finally we can say that we are also not less than the other countries of this world. Thank you very much for all your support and kind and patient hearing. Thank you.